Every year, scientists maneuver into dangerous jungles, deserts, oceans, and mountains to get up close to animals and, if they're lucky, discover a brand new species. And lucky for us, we get to see them. As these newfound creatures are uncovered, it's important for us to protect them. In the meantime, scientists are busy studying these new animals. These critters can inspire new materials, technology, and medicines too. Some of these animals, however, you can't unsee. They are that unusual. They're literally bizarre. But you know we love these animals as well. Here are the 15 most bizarre animals that will give you the chills.
That is a goonch. It's not a very big one.
Number 15. Goonch catfish. A giant mutant fish is believed to be targeting swimmers in an Indian river after developing a taste for human flesh. The goonch, a huge type of catfish, is believed to have been feeding on corpses thrown into the Great Kali after funeral ceremonies. Locals have believed for years that a mysterious monster lurks in the water, but now they think it's moved on from scavenging to attacking swimmers venturing into the river along the India-Nepal border. Last year, an 18-year-old Nepalese man disappeared in the river, dragged down by something described as like an elongated pig. The Kali River goonch attacks were a series of fatal attacks on humans believed to be perpetrated by man-eating 200-pound fish in three villages in India and Nepal. This is the subject of an episode about the Kali River goonch on the Animal Planet series River Monsters. This animal is indeed an unusual and mysterious fish. A member of the catfish species, it lives in some rivers in northern India and other rivers of the Asian subcontinent where the conditions are right. There is still much we do not know about the goonch in the wild. You want to know a little secret? If you smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell, you'll have superpowers for the rest of your life. So what are you waiting for? Time to fly! Number 14. The Hammerhead Bat. Digital editing has been responsible for the creation of images of some fantastically fictional-looking creatures. Many social media users wondered if they were witnessing a similar creation in an image of an odd-looking, large animal said to be a hammerhead bat. It's not difficult to imagine what your average bat looks like. They're often described as flying rats, and though there are a lot of different types of bats, the basic features are typically the same: small heads, pointy ears, and wings. With that image in mind, the hammerhead bat might come as a bit of a surprise because it doesn't look like your average bat. In fact, it actually looks like an unusual tiny moose. The hammerheaded bat is widely distributed in equatorial Africa. The species is locally common and is typically found in lowland tropical moist forests, riverine forests, swamp forests, mangroves, and palm forests where it roosts in trees. Although colonies up to 25 bats have been observed, the average hammerheaded fruit bat roost is fewer than 5 bats. The hammerheaded bat is sometimes considered a pest due to its diet and its extremely loud honking noises at night. In some places, it's bushmeat. Yeah, they eat them. Number 13. The Big Fin Squid. Big fins, or magna pinna squids, are one of the deep sea's more ethereal, unusual creatures. Little is known of these squids, as very few have ever been captured, although over the last decade, with the increased usage of remotely operated vehicles, more and more video is emerging. Their fins are up to 90% of the length of its body, and they have ridiculously long arms. The squid often will hold some of its arms at a 90-degree angle from the side of its body, which gives them the appearance of having elbows. The arms and tentacles of the squid are both extremely long and believed to be between 13 to 26 feet long. Very little is known about the feeding behavior of these squid, although scientists believe that they feed by dragging their arms and tentacles along the seafloor, grabbing organisms off the floor. But they may use a simple trapping technique, waiting for prey to bump into their super long arms. Several videos have been taken of animals nicknamed the long-arm squid, which appear to have a similar morphology. Since none of the seemingly adult specimens have ever been captured or sampled, it remains uncertain if they're of the same genus or only distant relatives. Number 12. Northern Tamandua. The northern tamandua is a medium-sized anteater with a tail, small eyes and ears, and a long snout. They have a long, extensible tongue that's covered in sticky saliva to capture the ants and termites. The fur is pale yellow over most of the body, with a distinctive patch of black fur over the flanks, back, and shoulders. These mammals spend a lot of time in the trees. They're mainly nocturnal, but may be diurnal as well. They're active for about 8 hours and then rest in the shelter of hollow trees. They also feed, move, and rest on the ground too, and their movement on the ground is clumsy because they walk on the outside of their feet to prevent their claws from sinking into the ground. When the northern tamandua are attacked, they stand up on their hind legs, drop the tail in the middle to form a tripod shape. In the trees, the tail wraps around the branch for support. However, on the ground, they lean up against a tree to protect their back. They use their arms to thrash at the predator with their claws. Tamandua are solitary mammals and have a strong odor. The odor signals the tamandua's presence, which sends animals retreating. Wouldn't you? Number 11. Cyanide millipede. For many, millipedes are amazing creatures, a marvel of natural engineering, purveyors of the most legs on the planet. But millipedes are amazing for another, less well-known reason. Many species create and use weapons against their enemies in ways that scientists are only beginning to understand. According to local lore, some can blind chickens. For some animals, a few millipedes are deadly to the touch. There are millipedes that seem immune to the poisonous effects of cyanide. Worse, they manufacture and use the chemical against their foes, and some may even sedate their enemies. One multi-legged creature is called Aphiloria polychroma. The species is found on the forest floor of southwest Virginia's Cumberland Mountains, and its colorful appearance is coated with cyanide as a deterrent to predatory birds. This is actually a fairly common defense mechanism among millipedes. How millipedes use their chemical weapons vary. Some passively ooze from their glands, others roll up to squeeze them out, and others actively spray them at predators. Curiously, unlike most living creatures, millipedes themselves are immune to the effects of cyanide. They produce all their chemical weapons in their own bodies. Number 10. The giant shipworm. Scientists have found live specimens of the rare giant shipworm for the first time. The discovery came about by chance when a team was working in the Philippines and found that the locals were eating them. They're a delicacy called tamalog, purported to have medicinal properties. Though its existence has been known for years, no living specimen has been studied until now. Despite its name, it's not really a worm. The giant shipworm is actually a bivalve, the same group as clams and mussels. The giant shipworms were once found all over the globe, but the team does not know how many are left. The rare and enigmatic shipworm is the longest living bivalve known to man. You can find these grotesque beauties planted in a shallow lagoon, immersed in the mud. Since the giant shipworms live in this habitat, it will use bacteria from the mud to feed. The most delicious part of their meal? The scent of rotting eggs. The reason for the smell is that the mud they live in spits out hydrogen sulfide. The sulfide is vital to their existence. They use it as energy to produce organic carbon that they feed off of. The process is similar to how green plants use sunlight in the process of photosynthesis. Number 9. Glowing sea turtle. You're definitely looking at a turtle glowing neon green and red. No, it's not radioactive, but it is an epic glowing sea turtle. The hawksbill sea turtle is the first reptile scientists have seen exhibiting biofluorescence, the ability to reflect the blue light hitting a surface and re-emit it as a different color. The most common colors are green, red, and orange. Biofluorescence is different from bioluminescence, in which animals either produce their own light source through a series of chemical reactions or host bacteria that give off light. Researchers never expected to find it in a marine reptile, so needless to say, this was cause for great excitement. Biofluorescence occurs when an organism observes light from an outside source, such as the sun, transforms it, and then re-emits it as a different color. Right now, scientists aren't too sure what's caused this biofluorescence. However, hawksbill sea turtles are one of the most endangered and protected species in the world, which makes them very difficult to study. But scientists love these sorts of challenges, and we'd love to see more glowing sea turtles. Number 8. The blue dragon. Here's a whole different kind of slug that you need to know about. The blue dragon sea slug. Though they look like the left-behind offspring of some alien creatures, these bizarre creatures are 100% Earthbred. It possesses abilities unlike any other creature on Earth. It stores the stinging powers created by the creatures on which it feeds, including venomous siphonophores and Portuguese man-o-wars. These cells are stored and concentrated, so when it's touched, the blue dragon can release these stinging cells to pack an even more powerful punch. They're actually not all that different from your average garden snail, just a lot more colorful and, as well mentioned, extremely poisonous. These beautiful but dangerous sea slugs can be found throughout oceans around the world, from temperate to tropical waters. So, if you come across one, it's best to admire its beautiful blue colors from a distance. These beautiful but dangerous sea slugs can be found throughout oceans around the world, from temperate to tropical waters. So if you come across one, it's best to admire its beauty from a distance. Number 7. Longhorned Orb Weaver. If you're ever walking around in warm tropical regions of the world or the rainforests of Asia, Africa, and Australia, be sure to keep an eye out for these intricate little jewels of the spider world. You'll be glad for a run-in with one of these eight-legged wonders. As members of the orb weaver family of spiders, the purpose of the disproportionately long body horns, however, remains a mystery. Many orb weavers build a new web each day. The spider will consume the old web, rest for approximately an hour, then spin a new web in the same general location. The building of a web is an engineering feat, begun when the spider floats a line on the wind to another surface. The spider secures the line and then drops another line from the center, making a Y. The rest of the scaffolding follows, with many more non-sticky silks being constructed before a final spiral of sticky capture silk. The third claw is used to walk on the non-sticky part of the web. Characteristically, the prey insect that blunders into the sticky lines is stunned by a quick bite and then wrapped in silk. Number 6. Diane's Bare-Hearted Glass Frog. Discovered in the Talamanca Mountains of Costa Rica and described from 6 specimens collected in the area, Diane's Bare-Hearted Glass Frog is the 14th species of glass frog known from Costa Rica and 149th overall. Due to the frog's resemblance to Kermit, the discovery attracted a substantial amount of attention in popular media. Tweets and news articles comparing the glass frog to Kermit helped images of the frog go viral. The glass frog's name originates from its translucent, organ-revealing bellies, though the lack of pigmentation is still a mystery to scientists. Their green coloration, on the other hand, helps the nocturnal frog stay camouflaged on the undersides of leaves during the day. The new frog may look like Kermit, but it's not quite as cuddly. Male glass frogs are very territorial and will grapple fiercely with other males who trespass on their territory. It's one of over 100 species to feature the translucent skin, whose evolutionary benefit remains unexplained. Central America in general, and Costa Rica in particular, is a hotspot for these creatures. Number 5. The Assassin Spider. Once upon a time, 165 million years ago, there lived a spider who looked like a pelican the size of a grain of rice. The pelican spider tiptoed under foliage in the leafy parts of the world, looking for prey to impale with the fanged, beak-like pincers at the end of its long neck. The happy ending to this tale is that pelican spiders still exist today. There are at least 26 known species of pelican spiders still creeping around Madagascar and South Africa alone. The most interesting feature would be the long neck the spiders have. The elongated neck area of these spiders is suggested to probably have evolved because of their diet, just like the long mouth parts. The longer the neck, the further the spider can reach to catch its fast prey. Looking at the long legs of assassin spiders, it's suggested that they're not that fast. And to compensate, the body parts elongated. While we already know a lot about these spider-eating spiders, they're still understudied by experts. In my opinion, that's gotta be the weirdest spiders out there. But there has to be much more that we can learn from these innocent little killers. Number 4. Saiga Antelope. Often said to have a comical appearance, the goat-sized Saiga Antelope has a flexible, gonzo-like nose that looks like a shortened elephant trunk, thought to filter out dust in the dry summers. The Saiga Antelope is superbly adapted to the harsh conditions of the semi-desert grasslands of Central Asia. These unusual antelopes have a distinctive large bulbous nose and live in what used to be vast nomadic herds, but sadly their numbers are plummeting and they're now critically endangered. Saiga herds once numbered in the millions, but the global population has declined rapidly to the thousands. The population size remained high until the second half of the 19th century, when excessive horn export began. The high price and demand for horns drove radical hunting. The number of animals decreased in all regions, and the migratory routes shifted southward. After a rapid decline, they were nearly completely exterminated in the 1920s, but they were able to recover. And by 1950, 2 million of them were found in post-war Russia. Number 3. The vampire squid. With a scientific name that means the vampire squid from hell, you'd expect the vampire squid to be a fearsome predator terrorizing the deep. This isn't the case. Instead, the vampire squid collects and eats drifting particles called marine snow, using two long, sticky filaments. It doesn't seem like much food to fuel a foot-long cephalopod, but it's enough for its slow lifestyle in a dark, low-oxygen water with few predators. Though it resembles both, the vampire squid is neither a squid nor an octopus. It's a unique animal that's been separated by scientists into its own group. Like many of its relatives, the vampire squid has 8 arms and 2 tentacles. It does not suck or drink blood, and instead gets its common name from its dark color and the skin that connects the arms, resembling a cape. When disturbed, the vampire squid inverts its cape, displaying large spines that line the underside of its arms. The vampire squid expels a colorless substance that contains numerous particles of bioluminescent, aka light-producing, material. These twinkling lights confuse potential predators. Number 2. Sarcastic Fringehead. The sarcastic fringehead is a small but fascinating fish that lives off the coast of California in Baja California in the Northeast Pacific Ocean. The sarcastic fringehead is a tube blenny, so called because they live in burrows or tube-like structures created by other animals. In the case of this species, the shelters are those created by burrowing clams or by empty snail shells. Some individuals have been observed living inside soda bottles or other man-made materials, and they're ambush predators, so they like to hide, then stake out prey in places that offer both protection and an open view. Known to be really cranky, French heads charge at anything that comes close, including divers, and it's been said they don't like to let go easily. Sarcastic French heads challenge each other by opening their huge mouths toward their rivals. The mouth's elaborate coloring and the extreme size allow the larger to dominate over the smaller. Oftentimes, their mouths are thrust so close, they're practically kissing. But eventually, after this love fest, the smaller French head surrenders and leaves. Number 1. The Shoebill. Of all the possible names, how on earth is it called the Shoebill? How about Death Pelican? But humans don't have to worry about this strange bird. Shoebills, which live in the swamps of tropical Africa, are after smaller prey, but only slightly smaller. They eat big fish like lungfish, eels, and catfish, and also crazy stuff like Nile monitor lizards, snakes, and baby crocodiles. That goofy-looking bill clapped onto the front of the shoebill's face may look like a cruel joke of evolution, but it's actually a lethal tool. You may not want to look at them too closely. That death stare will haunt you in your dreams. By now, we must have hit all the need-to-know bits about the shoebill, so you must be saying, sorry, but no. Are you ready for this? They crap on their legs. Yeah, they crap on their legs because it keeps them cool. As with other birds, the poop is mostly liquid, and heat from warm blood passing through the legs is used to evaporate the liquid waste, resulting in cooler blood circulating through the stork. The science is fascinating, but when you get right down to it, this already mean-looking bird with a huge clattering death bill now also has poop legs. Yeah, we said poop legs. You're welcome. Those were 15 bizarre animals that will give you chills. Thanks for watching.